Hey guys, I know it has been longer than usual that I've posted. How are you? So, stuff has been happening, guys. And I've evolved, guys. I've become someone completely different. I have a completely different outlook on life. It's like the person I am now, it's like I know who she is, and it's like, yes, bitch. Yeah, guys, shit happened, stuff happened, guys. So, not that my beliefs are any different, but it's like, I'm a completely different person, guys. And it's like, wow. So today's video, I know you guys want astrology on my channel, so that's why I tried to give you guys astrology. Before I start, sometimes I ask myself, like, am I too nihilistic or am I just too detached? Or am I both? Because I'm starting to question if I'm like asexual or is it like detachment? I don't know, guys. It's so weird. Guys, because it's like, I don't know, it's not like I'm a robot though, you know what I'm trying to say? Guys, it's so weird. I'm like, I've been questioning so much. This curiosity has been burning inside of me, and I think I'm finally getting answers, guys. Always seek to know more. Knowledge is fucking power, guys. Okay, so I want to do a Mars sign. I'm gonna try to like be quick with this. Okay. I'm gonna do Mars in Aquarius. So y'all guys, so you know, air sign vibes. Super unique and always looking for like inventive ways to do certain things and to reach what you plan in your life. It's a very like unique approach you have towards things and in your life. So I like giving examples of like your sun sign and putting that into perspective. So let's give an example of a Libra sun, right? And a life goal or a life purpose or life mission for you as a Libran would be, I don't know, what do you guys like? Let's say to create a fashion line, cool, you know, for my Libran females. And then with a Mars in Aquarius, you would do it in a way that's very inventive and that's very unique. So maybe your fashion line would be like out of the ordinary, or maybe you would do it in a way that reaches out to crowds who are not the norm. If you know what I'm trying to say, it's your Mars. You know, Mars energy is passion. It's lust. It's anger. Anger for you is very, very, very chilled. I think you guys tend to hold it in for a while, but you Aquarians are known to have bad tempers. Savage bitches though, savage bitches. I dated an Aquarius chick once. Yeah, she was a manipulative hoe. But you guys are cool if you actually like understand one, and if they actually open up and stop using you and manipulating you, they're actually really cool people. But other than that, watch out for the snakes. So very, very interesting people, and like you guys have like a unique, not otherworldly, but like unique approach in the sense. So it's very like different in a way. I don't know how to explain it, guys. Yeah. What other examples can I give? I need to make this video so short, guys. Okay. Yeah, what am I saying? Yeah, I think you guys are. I think it's different with an Aquarius moon and Aquarius Mars. Because my moon is on the cusp of Aquarius and Pisces, but I think it's different, like regarding what spectrum Aquarius is in. So, very, very chilled until you fucking explode. Until you explode, though, it's like that Aquarian anger is just not to be fucked with. Because you guys get very dangerous, and very rebellious as well. So yeah. I don't know what else I can say. I don't have a lot to say today. Yeah, guys. Do you recognize me? I don't recognize me. Who am I? Who is she today? Strange. And now you also know your Mars is your lust and your sexuality, but not in a Lilith sexuality, like just Mars sexuality is more based on how you like your sex and how you what you want in a partner or how you are in bed. Lilith sexuality is more deep. That shit is intense. It's the bad side of sexuality. But Mars is just, you know, how you are in bed and what's your tastes and your interests, you know. Very lazy. And you prefer to be submissive, sometimes dominant. Depends on your Venus sign. It can depend. A lot of you like to be, you know, just like lying there, cool, whatever, fucking lazy. It's really, really cool. If you actually like talk to them and chill with them, they're quite loyal if you know how to keep them. Very cool people, man. Guys, I'm seriously questioning if I'm like too detached for life now, like nowadays. But not in a bad way though. Like I like it. It's like I think it's the peak of spirituality that I was trying to reach for my own self, in the sense. And I finally found raw detachment, but like in a good way. I like it. Cause like I'm just so fucking peaceful, guys, but it's not like bad where I literally like okay, basically I can't connect with people, like it's just a thing. But like I don't know how to like get attached to people, but like it's not like bad detachment in the sense where I'm completely isolated. It's like good detachment because I've detached myself from all the bullshit, and it just feels amazing, guys. Yo, I feel like a fucking alien, like, but a